I want to try and get 3 points, but like we showed, we keep giving teams 2-0 head starts. So fight, we fought back again. We showed some great character, and you know, obviously the penalty would have won the game for us. So gotta compliment the players on that. I thought they dug in, and we didn't have a great first 20 minutes. Let's be fair, and they knuckled down. We talked a little half time, had a couple of adjustments, and you know, I thought the midfield got on the ball a bit more second half. Mona got in the game, Ali started to get in the game. And, you know, first off, we just couldn't find him. We were just kicking balls, and I think we settled in second half. And, you know, I don't know if it was the changes, a couple of changes with the young ones coming in, but, you know, I think we self-destructed almost in the first, you know, two poor giveaways for the two goals. But, I mean, all due respect to Emily, I mean, how Crystal Dunn's not on the plane to Canada after seeing that display is beyond me. But I thought Emily did a pretty good job on it, to be honest. It was a tricky, you know, they play together in club from New York, so they're used to playing against each other. But I thought Emily did a decent job on it. But Crystal was a headache all night, and shutting down the distribution, so I don't think we did a terrific job at it either. But the back three held in there. You know, Rachel, you know, she had not a great start for her, and then she settled in too. So all credit to the players, to be honest. They settled in, they showed some character. We've come back twice now from 2-0, and just don't want to make too much of a habit of it.
Why do you think it has been something where the slow starts, I guess, over the last two games and giving up these goals?
Well, I mean, the goals were just giveaways. I mean, they were just, you know, when you're passing the ball around the back, any type of mistake, technical mistake, you're going to pay for it. And you know, we paid for it on both occasions. And, you know, those things could happen in the 80th minute. Cause I think they just happened to happen early in the game. Now, we actually talked about before we played about how crucial the first 10 minutes were in terms of, you know, pinning Washington in and making it difficult for them. You know, they're coming into our stadiums, 14, 15,000 there. Let's put them under pressure. Let's see what they're made of. And it turned out the opposite way. You know, they picked it off almost from the kickoff, knocked the ball behind us, and then we got kind of got stuck. You know, they didn't allow us to play out. We didn't do a good job of playing out. But the work ethic was good. Just, you know, our pressure wasn't great tonight, so we were just a little bit off. It looked like we were just a little bit off. I don't know if it was we lost a little bit of rhythm not playing last week, so we had a game off. Sometimes when you're winning games and you keep playing and you're coming back in Chicago, we were in pretty good rhythm at the time, so I don't know if the week off hurt us, you know.
Mona Shim got her third goal of the season. Ali Long got her fourth goal. Ali Long helped contribute to that first goal. Shim assisted on the second. What can you say about how those two have played so far this season?
You just keep feeding the pasta every day and making sure that they're healthy. I'm just kidding. Yeah, I mean, they've both been really good. They're both obviously really important for us, especially in the final third. They've been getting all the points for us, basically. And I got to give Sarah a credit tonight. You know, it was her first game at the professional level, and I thought she handled herself really well. Hit the shot that I think Mona got on the rebound for the first goal, and I thought she held up the ball pretty well. It's not really her cup of tea holding the ball up. She's more of a Jodie Taylor type, you know, centre forward, likes to go in behind and cause trouble. And I thought she did well on the first day. And I said to Mara and Ali, you know, they've been playing with her in most of the pre-season, so it wasn't like we just brought somebody in and threw a shirt on her. She'd been playing with them most of the pre-season, so they played a lot of games together. And I thought they found each other well, and I thought second half Mona really got into the game, and you know, she provided the goal for Ali, and there was another couple of beautiful balls that she played through, one to Taylor, I think, one through to Kendall. But for that 20 minutes around when we scored the second goal and we got the penalty, we looked like we could go on and win the game, and then the penalty took a little bit out of us, I think, and you know, and then we were obviously forced into a change in the back, and give Alyssa Kleiner all the credit in the world coming on and playing against Crystal Dunn for a few minutes before we could get Emily over there. And it's not an easy matchup, but again, for Alyssa, but she did well coming in. You know, Kelsey came in up front too, another amateur came in up front. So hats off to those guys in their first performance.
Is Rachel Van Holmbeck okay?
Or? I haven't, to be honest with you. I came straight in here, no idea. You know, I think it was just starting to get cramp. You know, obviously she's come back off a hamstring issue, so she was starting to feel cramp. And I think if I had Crystal Dunn run at me for 5 minutes, I'd probably get cramp. Poor Odega, I think the two of them can run, and they've got a lot of pressure on you. And Nair was spraying the ball around, so I think we didn't do a great job of closing Nair down tonight. I thought she was very good tonight and caused us a lot of problems. And Joanna Lohman did well in the midfield. Hoosted did well in the midfield. I thought they were good tonight.
Two different situations in terms of squad selection. They're missing defenders and their starting keeper. You're missing a lot of forwards in the attack. How do you feel that that affected the teams tonight?
They're only missing Krieger, that's it. She hasn't played. I mean, she got concussion quite a while back, so they're a pretty settled team, I think, at this point. They don't really have a lot going out. For us, a little bit different, obviously, missing up front. AO comes in on Monday. Obviously, the Africans saw that. That'll be a huge plus for us. Just give us another weapon up front, which will, you know, the problem is when you got to start, you've only got two forwards and one of them's playing. You've only got another youngster on the bench to come in, and you know, they have no experience. So having AO will give us, you know, another player and give us some bite coming off the bench, which obviously you need that late in the game if you're chasing the game, especially at home. But I don't think I wouldn't say it affected us. I mean, I think Jacko was pretty seamless tonight. You know, we had a different forward in every game so far. We had Alex for one, then we had Jody for one, then we had Sink for one, and then we had Jacko for one. So we're sharing the load, and AO could be the next one. We could end up 5-5, you know, depending on obviously what her fitness level's like when she comes in. And Jacko had a good game, in all fairness to her, so it's up to Jacko to keep her spot, and she'll be working, I'm sure, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday to make sure she's in the lineup.